Peeps, what's up? Action Figure Junkie back with you with another custom G.I. Joe classified action figure. Now, who's this handsome fellow? This is my custom version of Alpine. So, let's get into it. What have we got here? Well, as you've heard me talk about before, if you've watched my other videos, Gridiron Studios is making some really, really cool stuff that you can kind of make customs of your figures or take your figures to the next level by just kind of making them cooler with slightly better weapons and slightly better gear. Well, they made an entire loadout for basically for making an Alpine. The pickaxe slides into the backpack. My only issue is this particular backpack really does not stay in this particular body very well. So, like I asked in my beachhead video, if you've seen it, if you guys have any comments other than I don't like the earthquake gum. It's just not my, it's just kind of gross. But anyway, Gridiron made a really cool backpack that's specifically for making an Alpine. It also comes with this helmet, hat, glasses, and mic combination, as well as this whole chest loadout. This whole chest loadout. See these back, damn, this backpack. Oh well, I love it when my videos don't go perfect. It's kind of, you know, what makes them mine. This cool chest loadout, which was very reminiscent of Alpine, and it came, like I said, it comes with a walkie, as most of them do. This chest loadout has another mag for that very iconic Alpine machine pistol. What else? Check out this knife. Some of them come with these really great knives. Whoo, that is a knife, Mike. Yeah, but the backpack does not stay in very well. I might. Anywho, if you have any ideas on how to remedy that fact, remedy that issue, let me know. The pants, because Alpine always had brown pants, comes from a desert snake eyes. I did not buy a desert snake eyes. I did buy the pants, just the pants. For this figure, because I tried painting Stalker's pants brown and they ended up just not coming out great. So this is, if you couldn't tell, is based on the Stalker body. If you're a customizer and you don't know, you can basically get it on Amazon for a song. They're like 12 bucks. The chest, the rope that goes around his chest, which was very reminiscent of Alpine, actually came from Shipwreck. This guy is definitely pieced from a lot of different places and a lot of different figures. I did not particularly need that rope for Shipwreck. I've never cared to see Shipwreck with a rope across his chest. Me personally, I'm glad that they sold him with it, because it definitely came in handy on Alpine, who, I mean, think about it, always had a rope around his chest. I mean, he does climb mountains, so of course he needs a rope around his chest. So that fit there perfectly. I did try some paint apps right around the shoulder butterfly joints. As you can see, those do not stay very well, even with primer. This custom, I'll be honest, is not my favorite work, is not my personal favorite work. The only thing I like about him is how creative I got with the pieces I used, you know. I mean, it's not too terribly creative to go drop 40 bucks on a really cool loadout, but, you know, the rope, the the pants, the pouches that came from my extra grunt, they're not being used right now on Hit and Run. So that's, I don't know. I do like the creativity of where the pieces I found, but the paint job is just, especially on the shoulders and butterfly joints, was not my best. But you know what? We all, you know, I don't know. If you have any ideas of how I could have done it better, please let me know. If any of you, as I can't even speak, if any of you are customizers and have good tips for keeping paint, even, I did use primer, I did use a good acrylic, it didn't seem to really take, but like on the knee joints and the back, it seems to always chip and fall off. Elbow joints, I have a problem with. If you guys have any tips, please leave them for me in the comments. But yeah, really cool head. And as you can tell, this is Stalker's head and body. I'm gonna take the backpack off because it's just gonna keep falling off. But it is really cool. It comes with that. This cool beige pouch comes out. I have it double banded so it doesn't fall out, because if I lost it, I'd be heartbroken. Grappling hook with rope. It's more of like a nylon stretchy rope, so it's not gonna break easy. Fantastic knife. So this backpack, I know Hasbro is making an Alpine, which kind of makes me wish I had waited a little bit, but I got a very strong feeling that whatever they do come out with and whatever they make, I'm probably gonna transfer this guy's amazing gear over to that figure. Oh yeah, so let's take off the helmet. As you can, once I take it off, you can see, oh, who's that? Stalker. But the glasses, the helmet, the mic, plus Alpine had a mustache, so kind of fits perfectly. There we go. So this is my Alpine. If I shot a picture of him climbing the side of a mountain, I think it would look really good on this body. Fantastic machine pistol. It looks so cool. It's very, very Alpine. That's pretty much it, my friends. Snake Eyes, desert Snake Eyes pants, Grunt's pockets on the legs, Stalker's torso, and then Gridiron Studios loadout gear to for the win to complete. Thank you so much for watching. Appreciate you all. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Please leave me a comment to tell me how to do my paint better. Whatever nerd thing you do, do you boo. And as always, in closing,